Hi, good day to you. Welcome back to another video on this channel. In this video, we'll be talking about the eye. It's going to be a straightforward topic. Okay, let's dive right into it. This is the front view of the eye. Of course, we will be more familiar with this as we see it almost every day. Okay, so let's start. The different parts on the front view of the eye are these. First, we'll be talking about the pupil. Pupil is just a hole in the center of the eye that allows light through, and the size is controlled by certain muscles that we will be talking about later. And right surrounding it will be the iris, which contains the muscles that control how large the pupil size is. Then the white of the eye is called the sclera. On the edges, not really obvious, will be the conjunctiva. It helps to moisten the eye. And the hairs that you can see over here will be the eyelash, and all of these will be covered by the eyelids. Hidden under the eyelids will be the tear gland. Okay, so these are pretty straightforward. We'll take a deeper look at the side view, cross-section of the eye, the eyeball. It sits at the orbit of the skull and rotates in it. Looking here, there's a lot of parts, and we will go from the outside to the inside. Okay, so corresponding to the previous image, it will be the eyelid over here, eyelash, the conjunctiva, the iris, and the pupil. Here, the little bulge over here will be the cornea. It is continuous with the sclera. Continuous means it's connected together. It helps to bend light rays into the eyeball. Next, the middle layer will be the choroid coat, and it links to the ciliary body or the ciliary muscles. So this helps to contract or relax to control the size of the lens. The ciliary body has suspensory ligaments that connects to the lens. All these work together to control the shape of the lens in order to focus between far and near objects. And the innermost layer will be the retina. It is a layer which is filled with nerves that are sensitive to light, photoreceptors. Okay, and they are split into different types called rods and cones, which we'll talk about later. And over here will be the blind spot, where the nerves exit the eyeball. So of course, where nerves exit, mechanically designed, it cannot hold retina at that layer. And there's a little depression, there's a little hole over here called the fovea, yellow spot, where images are focused upon. And all these nerves exit the eyeball as an optic nerve. Alright, and there are two gaps over here called the aqueous chamber and vitreous chamber. So aqueous chamber is of course filled with aqueous humor. Humor means fluid. Vitreous chamber is filled with vitreous humor. It's just a transparent fluid to allow light to pass through to allow images to form on the retina. So in the alphabetical order, A comes before V. So in front will be the letter A and then letter V. So it's easier to remember like that. Okay, now we talk about rods and cones. For myself, I like to remember it like cones. You can see it like a VLC cone or a road safety cone, whatever cone you call this. And a rod, I like to imagine it like a blind man holding a black and white stick. Okay, why? Because for cones, it helps us to see colors in bright light. Three different kinds of cones, red, blue, green. They help us to absorb light at a variety of wavelengths. It's like seeing these road safety cones in the day. And because of these, it doesn't work well in dim light. On the other hand, rods is like a blind person holding this black and white stick. It helps to focus on black and white images in low light. And okay, we talk about how the iris control the size of the pupil. Remember, the iris is lined with muscles, circular muscles and radial muscles. So these are very similar to the digestion chapter, where you talk about peristalsis. Recall that chapter, link in the top right corner. They work antagonistically, so means one will contract, the other will relax, vice versa. So in bright light situation, the pupils will shrink in size to not allow too much light to enter. Therefore, the circular muscles will contract. And in dim light, to allow more light in, the pupil has to enlarge. By doing so, the circular muscles will relax. And how do I remember? I only remember the circular muscles, and I just flipped the combination for the radial muscles. This is how the circular and radial muscles contract and relax. You just have to remember that contraction means getting smaller, and relaxation or dilation will be it getting bigger or longer. This phenomenon is controlled by the pupil reflex. Recall the previous chapter, which is the one we talk about the nervous system, in link in the top right corner. This is considered a cranial reflex because it is a reflex action that takes place in the head region. So light enters the eye, receptor in the retina is stimulated. It sends signal to the brain, relay neuron in the brain sends the signal from the sensory neuron to the motor neuron of the iris. And the iris is the effector. It will carry out the actions accordingly to the situation. This is the reflex arc of the pupil reflex. Okay, let's talk about vision. How do we see? Images come in the form of light rays, get refracted in the cornea, and they are further refracted in the lens, and then they are focused onto the retina. The image formed on the retina is upside down and laterally inverted. Laterally means left and right. It's inverted on the left and right. And of course, it's diminished in size. So pretty simple. And of course, all this signal will travel down the optic nerve into the brain. The brain will make sense of all this information. Okay, next we talk about focusing or accommodation, which is adjusting the lens on the eye to see clear images of items that are near or far. For items that are far, the ciliary muscles will relax. This pulls onto the suspensory ligament, which pulls onto the lens. The lens will become more elongated, and therefore, it will be able to focus the rays of distant objects into the fovea of the retina. Just remember that far objects, your lens becomes long. And of course, on the other hand, if you're looking at near objects, your lens will become short. In this case, the ciliary muscles will contract. As a result, the lens becomes shorter or thicker. This allows the light to be refracted into the fovea. The eyeball is connected to muscles called the rectus muscle. And of course, for it to turn to the direction it wants to see, that rectus muscle of that direction has to contract. So if it wants to look down, the lower muscle has to contract. We have come to the end of this topic, and that is all for today. Hope you enjoyed this video. Give it a like and subscribe. Share it with somebody that needs to see this. And I will see you in the next video. Bye.